May now request our speaker of the day, Mr. Sadiyatullah Husseini ji, CEO of Abric Software Solutions, to deliver his talk. Over to you, sir. Today.
This is a great privilege for me to be here this evening in the company of future business leaders and their trainers and participate in this important seminar. I would express my sincere gratitude to the organizers and particularly Dr. Abdul Azim for giving me this opportunity. I am asked to speak on the impacts of financial crisis on the information technology IT and ITES. These two things are different. IT is information technology and ITES, that is IT enabled services. So BPOs and other such sectors which are based on IT infrastructure, they are called ITES. So on these sectors, what impact the global financial crisis is having, so that I will have to analyze. I think what is the crisis and what are the rippling effects of this crisis on Indian economy, all these things have been discussed in detail. So let us directly come to our main topic, that is the impact of this crisis on IT and ITES market. So first, I will give a brief overview of the negative impacts, and then, more importantly, I will elaborate the opportunities that this crisis has created for Indian IT sector. So as far as negative impacts are concerned, before analyzing the impacts, let us remind ourselves that India is among those economies that are comparatively insulated from the impacts of this crisis. This point was discussed in the previous session also, that the main reason is tight regulatory regime that India has in place, and particularly the fact that our financial sector is not totally liberalized. So we are not very much connected to international financial scenario. So because of these reasons, Indian economy is relatively, India and China, they are relatively insulated from the impacts of this crisis. But the story with the IT sector is different. Why it is different? It is different because IT industry is mainly an export industry. Its main orientation is towards export. And it is deeply integrated with the world economy, global economy. So it cannot remain insulated from the global economic scenario. Let us have a look on the scenario of IT industry in India. In India, the IT and ITES, these two industries combiningly, they employ around 20 lakh, that is 2 million individuals directly. And indirectly, they provide employment opportunities to around 8, 9 million, that means 80 to 90 lakh individuals. And IT industry is mainly, as I have said earlier, it's export industry, export-oriented industry. 61% of the IT sector's revenue, they are from United States, 61%. And of this, around 30% revenue is from one sector that is called BFSI sector, banking, financial services, and insurance. These three sectors are combiningly termed as BFSI sectors. So 30% of our export revenues in IT sector, they are from this BFSI companies. So this is the scenario. So when US economy is slowing down, that is the 61% of our market, and financial sector is getting badly affected, 31% of our export is dependent on financial sector. So obviously, all these revenues are bound to be affected. So there are two areas of these effects. One effect is directly from the BFSI companies. I think in the earlier sessions, this has been discussed in detail, that the main manifestation of this crisis has been the collapse and shutting down of some big financial companies in the United States. Many of these BFSI companies were direct clients of India. For example, Bear Stearns, Lehman, they all were shut down. Their operations were seized for some period. So they all were direct clients of Indian IT companies. So either contracts were cancelled or they were downsized because they were to cut down their cost, they were to cut down their budgetary allocations. So IT contracts were either cancelled or they were drastically downsized because they were big clients of Indian companies. They were not small organizations. So the cancellation of these contracts had adversely affected the whole IT scenario in India. This is the reason NASSCOM, that is the umbrella body of Indian IT and service companies, NASSCOM has brought down its growth estimation from 30%. Earlier it was estimated at 30%. Now after this crisis, it has been brought down to 21%. So this is the one area where Indian IT industry has been affected. Another area is cancellation and slowdown of service contracting is not confined to these BFSI companies. When recession occurs, so fear of recession always bring a kind of conservatism. Means everybody becomes cautious. We are observing in Hyderabad also that people are not selling their properties. People are not buying their properties. Everybody is cautious and discretionary spendings, they are being drastically cut down. So this scenario is there in industry also. Clients are cautious in their discretionary spending and decision-making cycles, they are being delayed, they are being prolonged. 43% of Western companies, according to a report, 43% of Western companies are cutting back their IT spendings, and nearly 30% are scrutinizing IT projects for their returns. 70% of firms are renegotiating their contracts for lower rates. And 60% of US companies, they are cutting back on contracts. So this is the scenario. These are the major negative impacts that Indian IT industry is getting from this crisis. Charles R. Swindoll has said, "We are all faced with a series of great opportunities, brilliantly disguised as impossible situations. Challenges and temporary obstacles apart, this crisis has opened up many new windows of opportunities for Indian IT and ITS companies. In terms of upcoming trends, while there may be a few specific verticals like, again, this BFSI companies or mortgage and financial services that are directly impacted, but other sectors like healthcare, utilities, in other sectors, as the growth is expected to be as per projections." This is my analysis. And the reasons for this optimism, I'm going to enlist. The first reason, I'm grouping these reasons into three major groups. The first group of reasons is counter-cyclical policies. Counter-cyclical policies. I think I do not need to explain the phenomenon of counter-cycling in this gathering. An economic or financial policy that works against the current cyclical phase in the economy is called counter-cyclic. That is, counter-cyclical policies are ones that cool down the economy when it is an upswing state. When the economy is booming, so if you want to cool it down, you will put in place some counter-cyclical policies. And when economy is a downturn, the policies are oriented to stimulate it. So these policies are called counter-cyclical policies. So when economy is slowed down, governments take special measures to speed it up. All big countries, including United States and European Union, are taking up such measures. These measures are going to create new avenues for IT market. President Barack Obama of United States has elaborated his economic recovery plan in his December 6, 2008 address. He promised to create employment to the tune of 2 million plus jobs. It will require US$700 billion federal spending. This is very huge spending. And IT companies will certainly get benefited from this. I'm putting before you some of the measures that Barack Obama has promised to take up. Engineering, number one, engineering. President Barack Obama declared, I'm quoting from his speech, "We will create millions of jobs by making the single largest new investment in our national infrastructure since the creation of federal highway system in the 1950s. Means in the 1950s, there was a huge investment for infrastructure. Barack Obama is promising to take up a project that is on par with that 1950 project. So obviously, these projects will require specialized engineering and IT solutions like computer-aided design and GIS, geographical information system, to support infrastructure development. And Indian IT companies are bound to get benefited from these initiatives. Secondly, energy consumption. In energy sector also, economic recovery plan has promised to take major initiatives. Barack Obama said, I'm quoting, our government now pays the highest energy bill in the world. We need to change that. We need to upgrade our federal buildings by replacing old heating systems and installing efficient light bulbs. That won't just save you, the American taxpayer, billions of dollars each year. It will put people back to work. And particularly in the educational sector, there is very massive plan. And this massive plan, I think it is going to change the scenario, IT scenario in India. President Obama has promised, my economic recovery plan will launch the most sweeping effort to modernize and upgrade school buildings that this country has ever seen. We will repair broken schools, make them energy efficient, and put new computers in our classrooms. Because to help our children compete in a 21st century economy, we need to send them to 21st century schools. Obviously, these 21st century schools will need enormous volume of computer-related works. These school computers will require educational software solutions, networking solutions, content management systems, and this is bound to revolutionize the educational technology domain within IT sector and KPO market within the ITES sector. There would be increased usage of online learning solutions. Since there is a shortage of trained teaching staff, distant tutoring, that is the main core of Indian KPO industry, learning management solutions should find enhanced demand. And similarly, in medical sector also, he is promising to take revolutionary steps. In addition to connecting our libraries and schools to the internet, we must also ensure that our hospitals are connected to each other through the internet. That is why the economic recovery plan I am proposing will help modernize our healthcare system, and that won't just save jobs, it would save lives. So this was the first set of reasons for my optimism, that is recyclical initiatives. Then second, it is BFSI regulatory regime, business, banking, financial services, and insurance. In this sector, massive regulatory measures are being taken up. The economic crises are always followed by review of economic related legislations, regulatory measures, and review of the financial sector. The current massive economic crisis has pushed the world leaders to consider what is called a new Bretton Woods. I think you all might have heard Prime Minister Gordon Brown of United Kingdom. He has declared that we need a new Bretton Woods, means a completely new economic and financial scenario, a completely new financial regime. So it is the common belief that better control and risk management systems would have helped to control the cascaded effect of bad debt. So the world is looking for alternative control and regulatory measures. This will require the complete restructuring of financial regime. IT is based on structures only. The software that you provide, it mainly addresses to the structure of the economic regime or regulatory regime that is in place. So when this regime is going to change, obviously that infrastructure, that software, and that IT solution, it will also has to change. New structures means new software and complete renewal of IT-related assets. Companies will have to upgrade technology and redo programming. All this will definitely need substantial investment in new IT initiatives. For many years, big financial companies were investing 80% of their IT budgets just on maintenance. So this will have to change, and you will have to invest much more on generating new programs and taking up new initiatives. So this was the second group of reasons. Then third, mergers and acquisitions. The large number of mergers would necessitate, obviously, when this economic crisis was starting, then only it was being predicted that this will trigger major way of mergers, takeovers and acquisitions. So the large number of mergers would necessitate seamless integration of technology platforms, which would create new job opportunities. Merger activity is going to provide new outsourcing opportunities, as newly merged entities may have to look at additional or new providers to support the integration work and a broader global presence, especially when you take into account the huge size of combined international operations. So this is the first reason. Then second, the financial crisis is forcing mergers of huge, complex institutions. If you just consider the banks and financial institutions that have been merged in the United States, so you'll have an idea how the big organizations, they are merging together. And they are forming very huge, mammoth organizational setups. So huge, complex institutions that were initially ungovernable in the first place, so the only possible way these institutions can be managed now is with substantial investment in new IT applications that can keep track of all the activities of the underlying operations and provide online real-time controls that are meaningful. So this is the third set of reasons, mergers and acquisitions that will require integration, that will require huge IT applications. So this will also create great opportunities for IT sector. And then finally, fourth one, it is domestic market. Before this crisis began, Indian domestic IT market had already grown to the highest ever peak. Last year, it was the first time in 2008, it was the first time that the domestic IT market growth rate was higher than the export IT growth rate. The domestic IT demand grew 34% last year, while export IT growth was just 27%. And this was the first time in the history of Indian IT industry. So a recent study by McKinsey Global Institute states that India will witness rapid growth of its middle class. Middle class means those households whose income is between $5,000 to $50,000. So this group, this class, which now comprises of about 50 million people, that is 5% of population, will enlarge to about 583 million people, that is 41% of population, by 2025. So rising incomes, the creation of massive middle class, and growing population will propel India to become the fifth largest consumer market by 2025. Consumption will increase at an aggregate rate of 7.3% the next 20 years to reach nearly $1.7 trillion. So this huge market will require comparable IT infrastructure. So there is huge untapped domestic market that also create huge set of opportunities for Indian IT sector. I think in last 6 months, if you look at the big companies, their policies, you will have an idea how big this Indian domestic IT market is. Recently, means 3 months ago, IBM has successfully signed up huge IT outsourcing deals, such as the landmark US$1.2 billion project from Bharti Airtel Limited. And then since then, it has managed to sign on other telecom firms that include Vodafone, SR Limited, Idea Cellular Limited, Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited, and then banking organizations like Canara Bank and Union Bank of India, etc. So opportunities in verticals such as energy, BFSI, manufacturing, education, telecom, this is one thing that domestic market is offering to Indian IT sector. Then increased penetration of computers in the household, then increased investment in IT by central and state governments. Everywhere now you are listening the buzzword e-governance. So this e-governance is also a huge market potential that Indian IT market, IT industry has yet to trap. Then rapid adoption of broadband, increased usage of non-PC devices like cell phones and other such palm tops and other such devices. Increased focus of small and medium-sized software companies on domestic market. So all these things, they create a great pool of opportunities for Indian IT companies. Now finally, the conclusion is very simple. No doubt, this is the hard time for Indian IT industry, but this hard time will not continue for long. The crisis has opened many new windows, and Indian IT sector has grown matured and dynamic enough to trap these new potential markets. It is not the scenario today is not same as that it was in dot-com period. In dot-com period, when crisis occurred, Indian IT was badly affected. But now, the Indian IT sector is matured enough to absorb and to insulate the effects of such crisis. With a little vigilance and strategic changes, the crisis can be turned into an opportunity. I think the following strategies can help. I'm enlisting 2-3 strategies that can help the Indian IT industry. Number one, trapping the domestic market and helping in accelerating the growth of IT infrastructure development in India. This should be the first important priority for Indian IT market. Second, taking a different route on marketing front, looking for avenues in the neighboring economies, especially in Middle East and China, and earlier route of focusing blindly and singly on US market should not be continued. This is second. Then third, carefully watching the economic measures of the new establishment in United States and trapping the opportunities created by new counter-cyclical measures. A few counter-cyclical measures I have enlisted. There are many other such measures and such other policies that are being adopted and that are bound to create opportunities for Indian IT sector. So they'll have to be watched carefully and trapped. And then finally, number four, focusing on the transformation and upgradation to get prepared for the challenges ahead, improving utilization and enhancing productivity. On employment front, this strategy will create unlimited opportunities for the efficient and bright workforce. Inefficient and backbenchers will continue to lose. Companies are cutting down non-productive employees and now will perceive with the performance only. Means there is wide-scale speculation about cutting down, about layout, about firing. But my analysis is that companies, they are cutting down, they are laying off only inefficient and non-performers. For performers and for efficient employees, the opportunities will continue to grow. So friends, more than the hard times, I think we are passing through very interesting times. It is said that luck is something that happens when opportunities meet preparations. Luck is something that happens when opportunities meet preparations. So opportunities are already there. If Indian IT sector gets prepared and courageously go beyond the known avenues and explore the new horizons, we will definitely see a completely different picture in the coming times. Thank you very much.
It was a pretty informative talk. I believe I'm audible. Yeah. So it was quite an informative talk, even for me, who I happen to be into IT and do a lot of consulting for IT firms. When it was a real true positive side of it. And the other day in the morning, I was coming with my friend. He was from Apple Ops. The person was quite depressed. I said, what happened? You know, he said, you know, Chetan, this tough time to go ahead. Yesterday itself, we had a pink slip given to almost around 150 employees in our organization, and 300 more are to flow. I don't know my name is there in that list or not. I said, yes, you're right. You know, when I talk about this title, it was a wonderful title. It talks about global financial crisis and the reality or myth. You know, when you talk about these two terms, it's wonderful. Because when you talk about a crisis, if you are a part of it, then it's a reality for you. And if you are not, it's a myth for you. Simple. So when you go by that particular thing to move and talk by Mr. Sadayatullah Husseini ji, it was wonderful where he was talking about the positive side of the crisis, you know. That's where India stands to gain about it. We have been a robust country right from the beginning. Possibly when I was hearing to Mr. Matthew Joseph also, who was talking about, you know, how actually things went wrong and what is that particular thing could be done and why it's a rosy picture for us to move. So talk about that export-oriented IT, that is what where we were doing. And I mean, the basic thing which always bothers us is India has been a huge potential for IT development to go in across. But can we boast of anything from our own product? Absolutely no, you don't have. You know, all the Indians do that export part to go, and we don't have a product on our own name or something to move. And that is where we lack. We are basically into a service where you do some service and get revenues for you, or you said Forex about it. The mindset. Which is the basic factor which drives this crisis to move on. You know, the basic thing which I was talking to some of the expert forums when we do interact with people, so, you know, the basic thing which happens here is the psychological crisis. It's rather than a true crisis to go in. It is basically based on your mindset. You perceive. The reason why, you know, other day I was reading on a paper, the gold, which is supposed to be one of the investment sources, is 16,000 rupees, 10 grams. So what has happened in that? Look at back to it. People started thinking the prices are going to go in and the stocks coming down and things move and the global crisis is going to hit. What I can put in? I can put it in a sector, the investments, where it's going to be stable. Oh, that particular thought of stability to move, and people anticipated, you know, when I mean, talk about Indian financial crisis, we really don't have much of the crisis. Some of the reasons where we are trying to talk about, let's say, Joseph was talking about 8,000 rupees square feet flat or apartment coming back to 4,000 rupees. I'll tell you something quite interesting into it. Why? I mean, I'm not a finance man, but as a common sense, I was thinking about it. You know, there's always black and white in Indian policies to go on. So if I buy an apartment, let's say, or if I buy a property to move on, what happens here is, if the price is, let's say, around 50 lakhs, which I officially pay, I mean, to the person whom I'm buying to move on, when it comes to registration of my property, I do have a valuation because I don't want to pay tax. And I don't want to give it to the government just like that, because I don't think they do something for us. So obviously I'll cut down my price and say my 50 lakhs property is somewhere around 25 lakhs to 30 lakhs. Now, when the bank gives you a loan on it, it doesn't give you 100%. So it gives you somewhere around 80%, 85%, 90%. Now, in this crisis also, when the property price of 50 lakhs falls down to 25, still banks are not going to lose. Whereas in Western countries, it's not like that. You know, whatever is the price, the bank gives you 100%, 110% of loan on it, so that you can always buy a necessary to go in with your house, and they don't look at the backing. And as a taxpayer, I have to declare everything across. So a 50 lakhs property is registered at 50 lakhs. Now the crisis comes. Bank cannot realize its money because I cannot sell. There's no buyer to move in. So in that case also, the financial crisis which is affecting the West may not be possible in India, and talk about other sectors also. That's my understanding of it. And also, my discussion with banks could go in, because even as a common man, if you go to a bank and you see it, it moves in. Then we have a wider base. You know, we have to go in and understanding. I don't really, you know, depend on credit to move in as a major part of my finances or working across. So off late the boom is in. I mean, when I discuss with my father, he always tells, Chetan, you know, that the times are good for you. I mean, 30 years back, we go back, there's no wealth at all, zero wealth. Actually, we never saw wealth to move, and even for a classman officer to go, we never had, you know, even a scooter to move and a two-wheeler to go across. We had to go on a bicycle. But today, look at that. A person who is 20 years, 21 years, moves around in a four-wheeler. An average age of buying a property has come down to 25. Whereas we never thought about buying a property when we are on the verge of retirement, possibly through retirement benefit, we buy something across. So go back and understand and look. Off late, it has created a lot of wealth. And I believe and I surely endorse that IT was one of the basic sectors which really contributed to this financial hunch. Otherwise, we never would have seen that money. When had we thought about Gachibowli to be such a great place? I remember in 91 when I was coming to my university. I mean, the streets were deserted. There were no buildings. It was quite jungle kind of thing. But today, you boast about 100 rupees crore an acre. I mean, that's something which is high. Now, this particular thing has increased just because of an IT thing to go in. So, Mr. Sadeedullah Husseini, he was perfectly right when talking about there's always positive side for your IT to move in. I mean, the impact of financial crisis on IT and IT years possibly has been high. I mean, in Western countries and India being dependent on that, We have to face it, you know, that happens, but we are already started consolidating it on path. When there's a hype, there's a demand, people start getting into it. Now, when there's a tough path, people slowly start pulling out of it and look back at the traditional sectors. Now, we were trying to go back to, you know, infrastructure. We are trying to go back to industry and heavy metals. We are trying to go back to petrol, and we are trying to get better back to something else, wherein we are looking at a real-time growth. So possibly, as well said by him, we can think that this particular global crisis is a beautiful opportunity for a country like India to move ahead. That is where the entire things go on. I mean, I was really so happy about such an elaborate remarks which were given by him on this subject, wherein we talked about how actually, in spite of being in the crisis, I mean, US supposed to be one place where the crisis is too high. I mean, the other day was there, I mean, it's terrible. You have a lot of fear. People are not getting sleep. They are popping up. One industry which was going to do well, in spite of all this crisis, would be the pharma industry. You know, that's where when you have a tough time, you fall sick. And when you fall sick, you are supposed to take medicine. So one industry to go well there is the pharma industry, and IT also has a big role to play there. So let's always think that IT is doing wonderful thing for people. At least one industry goes down, there's always something else. You know, we had that basic concept, don't keep all your eggs in one basket, has been helping us around. Had it been only investment into IT or any sector which is suffering today, you'll never have that kind of thing. But because our asset base, or you talk about finance base, is quite high, where you talk about diversified investments, that's going to really help you out to move in. So even the President Obama's on his speech, I believe I was awake to see that talk and thing to go, and halfway I felt asleep and I slept. But you know, when I read back in the newspapers and heard to you now, and I was more clear about what he spoke on that. So when you talk about the positive optimism, I mean, people also realize at a given point of time that yes, what we have been pursuing today is a mirage. Possibly that could have helped a lot of things to move in. I mean, this bubble had to come. You know, if not today, it would have come after 2 years or 3 years or 4 years. But we were supposed to be there. You know, there was a great economic depression and we all came back out of it. We had a rosy economy today. So there's always a cycle. There's a phase. This phase comes in, goes out, we always go on. But if that particular negative impact of the phase, if we take into our generations to move in, it becomes very difficult. You know, last year when IT was really bad from last year on, so if you go back, except this Satyam's crisis, but people always knew IT had a problem where things move on. The admissions to the basic courses in IT was tough. So when that particular thing was there, people started looking at the traditional sectors to move. So in that particular context, you know, there was a great demand for our 10 years, 12 years back, when I choose to get into business management, most of the people said, Chetan, you are doing a mistake. I said, I mean, I don't know when that was, where I was thinking, why is a mistake? They said, no, IT is something which you can give you lots of inputs and lots of career opportunities for you. You rather choose an information technology than business management. But you know, my conscience and my mind was very clear. I said, no, I want to make a career. I mean, I have a passion for teaching and research, and business management is one area which always has been a passion for me. So that way I got into that particular thing. And today you talk about how people are shifting from IT to this. Just not a shift, but IT is an enabler, would be an enabler. When you could see everything what you talk about today, the mobile phones, the talk about internet banking, you talk about any solution to go in, we cannot really live without information technology to move in. That is one reason why, in spite of a crisis, we do require IT. It is one tool which is going to help you out. So always there's a rosy picture about it. Only thing is, you know, a beautiful rose dust comes with a thorn. If you are able to catch that stem without a thorn, obviously you'll not get a pick, and you'll always be happy with the flower in your hand than a pick in your hand. So that is what is the basic problem now. When you talk about the other side of it, this the global financial crisis is there, but there's always a way out. A crisis always gives you an opportunity and says, yes, I am there. And human beings have always been people who challenged and who won. Obviously, we have a divine support there and we believe in it. Until you are ethical and you do your work well, the rewards are going to flow. So keeping that optimism well, I would like to conclude by saying that, yes, this particular crisis is not a big crisis. You always understand, you know, because it's not affected me, I'm not talking like that. But you know, it's a fact. Those who are affected also, it's a temporary phenomenon. Don't get depressed. It's psychological. You'll surely come out of it as short as possible. It's a short-lived phenomenon. So with this particular thing, I thank the organizers of this particular seminar, having a title which is apt for today. I believe it had cleared lots of confusions which all of us had in our minds about, is it a myth or a reality? So wishing you all the best, and thanking Dr. Azim.